हरे कृष्णा, आप सभी का ड्रॉपलेट्स ऑफ नेटर चैनल में स्वागत है। आज हम 13th चैप्टर का बर्ड व्यू देखेंगे। टुडे वी विल बी सीइंग द बर्ड व्यू ऑफ द 13th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद्गीता, ओवरऑल एनालिसिस फ्लो चार्ट स्टडी ऑफ 13th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद्गीता। वी विल नॉट बी गोइंग इन द डेप्थ ऑफ द 13th चैप्टर। वी विल बी कवरिंग ओनली द फ्लो चार्ट स्टडी, हाउ द श्लोकाज गो एंड what are the flow of the shlokas in the 13th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. 13th chapter is entitled Nature, the Enjoyer and the Consciousness. Arjun asks very wonderful questions in this chapter and Krishna gives excellent answers to those questions. 13th chapter is having total 35 shlokas and let us see how the flow of the shlokas is going. First question is asked by Arjun. Arjun is asking here in the first shloka. In one shloka, he is asking six questions. Six questions in one shlokas. What are those six questions? First, he is asking about Prakriti. What is Prakriti? What is Purusha? What is Kshetra? What is Kshetragya? What is Gyan? And what is Gyeyam? Means knowledge to be gained and what is to be known about. So Krishna very intelligently answers all these six questions in the rest of the chapters in very detail. Second to seventh shloka, Krishna describes Kshetra, Kshetragya and Jnanam. So Kshetra he answers in third shloka, Kshetragya he answers in fourth shloka and Jnanam he answers in fifth shloka. Like two and second and third shloka, he says Kshetra is body, Kshetragya is both soul and Krishna, and Jnanam is the perfect knowledge. In the fourth to fifth shloka, Krishna promises to explain six topics about Kshetra and Kshetragya and quotes the authorities. Then in sixth and seventh shlokas, Krishna explains the composition, the qualities, the changes and the origin of the body Kshetra. So he explains all the detail about the Kshetra. Then in the 8th to 12th shloka, Krishna explains Jnanam, the process of acquiring knowledge. And the process of acquiring knowledge, he gives 20 elements of knowledge, starting with humility and pridelessness, non-violence, tolerance and so on. Krishna explains that these factors are the elements of knowledge and rest all are not the knowledge. If you want to be really knowledgeable person, you have to be humble, you have to be non-violent, you have to be tolerant. And this is the significance, this is the symbol of you having knowledge. Then in the 13th to 19th shloka, Krishna explains about Gyeyam, that is object of knowledge. What are the object of knowledge? What one should know? Krishna says, soul and super soul are the only objects of knowledge. The qualities of the super soul is also described in these shlokas. Then in the 20 to 26 shlokas, Prakriti, Purush and their union is described. How, what is Prakriti, what is Purush, and how they are united with each other. Krishna says that Prakriti causes all material entanglements and material entanglement causes and effects. So all the things happening in this world are caused by Prakriti only. Jiva associates with the modes and changes bodies and causes his own happiness and distress. So why one particular living entity is happy and other is distressed? What is happening? Who is changing everything? Is explained in these two shlokas. Then 23rd shloka, Krishna is explaining super soul is the real Purusha. Then 24th shloka, Krishna says knowing Prakriti, Purush and Gunas, one can attain liberation. What are them? What is the method of attaining liberation is to know the Prakriti, Purush and Guna. Even after we know these three things, there are various methods for attaining liberation that is described in the 25th and 26th slokas, different methods of liberation. Then in the last section is about 27th to 35th shloka, Jnana Chakshu, the vision of knowledge. Krishna gives the particular vision of knowledge. In 27th shloka, Krishna says, every entity is a combination of Prakriti and Purusha. A true seer's vision of Jeev, Prakriti and Paramatma. 32nd to 35th shloka, finally Krishna concludes that the non-doership of the soul means the soul doesn't do anything and Prakriti is the controller and the doer of everything. In this way, Krishna, in the last chapter, Krishna has described about Bhakti Yoga. So in this chapter, starting with the 13th to 18th chapter, this Krishna explains the Jnan aspects of the Bhakti. How Bhakti can be done by Jnan, knowledge. So this ends here. And next chapter, next video we'll be doing the 14th shloka, 14th chapter, bird view of the 14th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Hare Krishna.